Today, the role of Quint Chamberlain will be played by Josh Taylor.
Here you go.
Can I get some more coffee?
Oh, sure. Sure. How come you're alone?
I'm not alone. Marcus and Dahlia are here somewhere.
Oh.
Marcus had to make a phone call.
Okay, coffee coming right up.
Thanks.
Hey, Chef.
Matt.
Hi.
Did you get a chance to talk to Zachary? Did you find out anything?
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing? I thought you were on my side with this.
I blew it, okay, Matt? Zachary's acting kind of weird. Like he's hiding something.
How's Vanessa doing?
Not very well on the plate. Now her eyesight's beginning to fail.
Well, may I see her?
Yes, of course. God be with you.
And your sister. It's me, it's Zachary.
Zachary!
Hi, how are you?
Hi! Hi, how's Matt? Have you seen him? Is he happier? Has he started to get on with his life?
Mama. Why did you tell me about the baby you gave up? What do you want me to do about it?
Find him for me, Reva. Please. Find your brother and make sure that he's all right.
Find the baby.
I want him to know about me. I want him to know that his mama always loved him. And I never forgot him. Promise me. Promise me that you'll find your brother.
No, if I can, Mama. My life is...
I made a promise to God and to my boy that I would find him one day and make sure that he was happy. Honey, I can't do that anymore. You have to do it for me.
I don't even know where to begin. I mean, you're not even positive that it was a boy.
It broke my heart to not see my boy. But those doctors, they thought it would be better for me. Huh. But remember, I told you that I thought I heard the nurses saying that it was a boy.
I know, but that's still not much to go on.
Well, you started the hospital. St. Agnes in Chicago. Now, look through their records. And September 30th.
Chicago, Mama, you went so far away.
Well, I couldn't stay in Tulsa. Too many tongues wagging about everything that's none of everybody's business.
No, I remember.
I stayed with your aunt, my sister, for those last 3 months. And that's when you kids stayed in Tulsa.
With Miss Myrtle, I remember that.
Yeah.
You know, Mama, I really think you need to get some rest. I'm just...
No. There's something else. I had a cameo brooch that my mother gave to me. And I asked the nurse to pin it on the baby's blanket so that he would have something of mine. It was that old cameo brooch that they had, that bent clasp. You remember?
I do remember.
Rusty and I used to play with that when we played dress up.
Yes. Now maybe he kept it. And maybe you'll recognize it.
Oh, Mama, that's like looking for a needle in a haystack.
Find my boy. Find him. It's the last thing I want in this world. Please. Please, Reva, do it for me.
I will try to find him. I will find him.
Bless.
Now you have to promise me something. You have to promise me that you're going to get well and that you're going to get up out of this bed and you're going to come and live back in Springfield with me and Buzz.
Yeah. I want to see Joshua.
Joshua, why?
Never you mind. I want to see him and make sure he's alone.
Wants to see you.
Here, I'll go with you.
No, Pop, she wants to see him alone.
Did she say what?
No, she didn't say.
Hi. I understand you want to see me now.
You were always so strong and so handsome.
You're trying to butter me up for something, aren't you?
You know me too well.
Yes, I do. What's the deal?
I want to talk to you about Reva. And you.
I can't see you as well as I used to be able to.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. I'd know you anywhere, anywhere.
Thanks.
Okay, tell me. Tell me about everybody.
Well, Bill's okay. It's been tough not having you around, but
yeah.
He's slowly moving ahead.
Oh, good. And he and Matt are getting along better?
Well, they both understand what the other's going through.
And Dinah?
Dinah's very happy with Hart. Apparently, Roger's giving her the divorce.
He is? But she's happy. And Roger hasn't told anyone that he saw me in at the airport?
No, not that I know of.
Good. I don't understand that. That's not like him, is it?
Well, let's hope he has other things to do.
I do.
Well, yeah, I hear Peter loves nursery school. He's doing great.
Oh, good. What sweet, sweet boy. How's Matt?
We've been through this, Vanessa.
I know the last time he... You told me that he was miserable, that he couldn't accept my loss. Is he better? Is he any happier?
I wish I could say he was. But, I think it's worse.
What do you mean?
I mean, he's building you a house.
Building me a house?
Your dream house on Lake Geneva, the one you guys were planning before you disappeared. Matt loved you with all his heart, Vanessa. He's not about to give that up.
Wait a minute. I don't understand this. He doesn't know that I'm alive, does he? He can't. He can't know.
No, but he feels it in his heart. Now, somehow he senses the truth, and he's holding on to that. I think he's waiting for you to come home.
Matt, slow down. All I said was I think he's hiding something. He's a really nice... sensitive, caring guy.
Who's full of secrets.
So?
So you don't know him. That's my point, Michelle.
But you want a list? The things I know and like about Zachary Smith. Is that it?
You could fill up the fingers on one hand.
He lives by himself. But he doesn't seem to mind that. He's very involved with the lighthouse renovations. So he's a hard worker. And another thing. He's not into material stuff. So he takes all of his money, wherever he gets it from, and puts it into his work. Can I stop now? I'm running out of hands.
I've changed my mind, Michelle. I want you to stay away from Zachary.
Oh, don't worry about it. He's planning on leaving Springfield in a couple months anyway.
He said that?
Yes. But I'm hoping he changes his mind.
You mean you're going to try to help him change it?
If I can. I've never met anyone like him, Matt. I don't want him to go away.
Forget it, Michelle. Stay away from him.
No way.
I mean it.
Look, I already have a meddling big brother. His name is Rick. I'm not going to take it from my cousin, too.
Look, if I let you get involved with this guy and you get hurt, I'll never forgive myself.
I can handle it.
Michelle, stay away from Zachary. You got it?
I thought I knew the rules for better protection.
And Bridget is upstairs putting Peter to bed, so, and you just can't sneak around and abduct me like this.
I did not abduct you. I just, I borrowed you for a moment, okay?
Oh, for heaven's sake. I have customers to serve.
It's Tashua. And this fragment fits the other shards I found.
Are you sure?
And I think what it says is the moon holds a secret to happiness.
Really? The moon, that's it?
Yeah, why don't you give it a try?
No. Yeah, I told you I'm busy. I've got a restaurant full of very hungry people.
Nola, what about the pottery?
You know, on my day, when I'm at the dig, when I'm scheduled to work there, I'll take a look at it.
Okay, all right. If you want to put off taking a peek at the most important archaeological find in decades. I mean, if you want to remember that on this potentially historic day, you were serving burgers and fries, hey, I'm not going to argue with you.
Can I, take a look at it. Oh, goodness, look at this.
Oh, well, you've got it wrong.
I do.
Yeah, it doesn't say anything here about the moon holding the secret to happiness.
Really?
No.
Well, what does it say? Well, I mean, if it's not the moon that holds the secret to happiness, what is it?
Zachary's not going to hurt me.
How do you know that, Michelle? You're getting involved with the guys leaving town.
We're not involved like you mean. Nothing's going on between us.
I'm worried about you.
Well, don't be. I told you I can handle it.
Yeah, well, you know, I didn't think anything would happen with me and Vanessa either.
Are you blaming Zachary for Vanessa's death? I know you're upset, but it doesn't make any sense at all.
Look, I'm not saying that he did something to her. I'm just saying I think the guy knows more about what happened to Vanessa than he's telling me. And I'm going to get to the bottom of it if it's the last thing that I do.
Marcus, you know, if there's anything you want to tell me, anything at all, you can. You know that, right?
Yeah, sure. Thanks. What's with you today, anyway?
Oh, nothing. I was just afraid that maybe something was bothering you.
No. No, nothing at all.
Okay.
Well, look who's here. So do you think he's actually going to admit that he came looking for me, or do you think he's going to say that it was some coincidence that he happened to show up next door to where I live? This guy.
Rick, I thought that was your car outside. Charles, I didn't expect to see you here.
Well, I don't work all the time. I like to unwind every now and then. You care to join me?
Sure. Why not? I was really glad to hear about you and Vivian getting back together.
Back together? That's stretching it a little bit. But we are both committed, which is a good thing because we got a lot of work to do.
Oh, I understand. I hope you make it.
So do I. I hear you've decided to stay in Springfield.
I'm not too sure about much right now, Charles, but I am sure about that.
Any plans?
career-wise? Haven't decided yet. I'm just lucky the judge decided I could do more good for people if I didn't go to jail.
You are still an important voice, Rush, you know?
People keep telling me that, Charles. But I'm not so sure that I'm still the right person.
Oh, Griffin, that's just a bunch of bull. Millions of people look to you for leadership. They look to you for inspiration. What are you going to do, just check out on them now?
Let them down once before.
Listen, I am not your biggest fan. But I'm not going to let you get away with that one. There are lots of things, 1,001 things you can do to make up for what's happened.
Charles, I have been forced to take a good, long, hard look at my life and where it's been. And let me tell you, I don't like what I see.
Fine. Fix it.
And that's exactly what I want to do. See, Charles, as far back as I can remember, my priorities have been all screwed up. I mean, yeah, I said a lot of right things, and with God's help, I maybe even did some good. But the fact is, Charles, I wasn't doing it for the right reasons.
The right reasons? What does that mean? You got the job done. In the end, that's what matters, don't you think?
The point is, I could have been so much more effective if I'd been coming from a place of honesty. I used the cause to feed my ego, to avoid taking responsibility for my family, especially my son. If I've done some good for our people along the way, well, that's great. But the fact is, Charles, that the day finally comes when it's about more than that. When you gotta look at yourself in the mirror. When there's not a cheering crowd of people in front of you telling you how wonderful you are. That's when you know that you are not the great man that you've been pretending to be. That you are, in fact, not really much of a man at all.
I've never heard you talk this way before.
I've never had to talk this way before, Charles.
Excuse me, can I talk to you for a second?
Yeah, sure.
What's up? It's Marcus. I think he's keeping a big secret from me.
I know the feeling.
Yeah, except I think I know what this one is, and it scares me half to death. I think Marcus has a child.
You okay? As quiet as a church mouse.
I'm
just rare for you.
Tired.
Mama had your ear for a long time, sister. What all she have to say is so important.
It was private, Pop. You know, mother and daughter stuff.
You and your mama, you always did have those hush-hush conversations. Two of them talk for hours and never run out of things to say.
You don't have to tell me. I see the phone calls to Italy.
We just lost so many years when I was gone, you know?
You have no idea how lost she was without you, sister.
Just wish that I'd come to visit her, you know, when she was healthy instead of when she's like this.
I was planning to make the trip. Cop salary, I couldn't quite swing it.
Yep. Your mama understands all that. She's just glad you're here now to have her youngins around her.
I wonder what Sarah had to tell Josh.
It's not over for you and Reva.
Sarah, Annie and I are trying to build a life together. It's too late to go back now.
No, it's never too late. Everybody makes decisions that they regret. Some you can fix, and some you can't, but, well, this one between you and Reva can be fixed.
Sarah, I love you. I respect what you're saying here. I do. But it can't. Reva and I can't be what you want us to be. Not now.
Honey, you don't have to be afraid to start over.
That's not it.
You don't have to be scared.
I'm not scared.
But you and Reva never had an easy relationship.
No, it was like fingernails on a chalkboard.
I always thought it was more chemistry than friendship.
Oh, come on. You know, Reva, you know that she's always been too much for me. She's out there. She's loud. She does things in life without really thinking them through. She grabs on to life more so than she can possibly handle at one time.
There are soulmates in this world. There are people who were meant to end up together.
Sarah, Reva and I had our time together. It's over. I think it's the best thing for everyone concerned.
You don't fool me for 1 minute. Reva loves you. And you love Reva. And know my daughter, Joshua. Reva will love you come hell or high water till the day she dies. Tell me you don't love her right back. Go on. Tell me.
My wife, or Reva to leave Buzz.
Take it from a dying old woman. Life doesn't mean one whit if you are with the wrong person. I am sure that Buzz and Annie are very nice folk, but your heart belongs to Reva. And hers belongs to you.
Not anymore.
Oh. The love you two have together is bigger and stronger than anybody else. And you'll have it forever.
Sarah, I really hate to disappoint you. But I just cannot tell you the things you want to hear right now.
It doesn't matter. I know the truth. And whether you want to admit it or not, you know it too. I'll be watching over you. I'll be keeping an eye on you and Reva.
Listen, we love you, okay? I'm gonna take you home. And you're gonna get better. And you're gonna watch your kids, your grandkids, grow up.
No, I'm not. But I want you to look after Reva. Now, you promise me.
Zachary, you have to help me convince Matt to move on.
I told you, Vanessa, I can't promise anything like
that. You have to do it.
I've already gone against every vow I've made.
You know that the only reason that I staged my own death was to help him. So that he could find somebody to love, so that he could be free. That was the only thing I could do for him. You've got to help me.
I know how hard this is for you.
Do you? Then help me.
I've already done everything I can think of to help him. I don't even know what to do.
I do. There's something that you can do. And it involves Nola.
Well, I think you're definitely right. It's a piece of the urn. But it doesn't say the moon holds the secret to happiness.
Well, what does it say?
Well, it says the Paschuan symbol for hold. And under are very similar, so you confuse the two?
Oh, okay. So it says the secret to happiness is under the moon.
That's it. I'm, it's an easy mistake to make, because the Paschuans had an unusual sense of idiom.
Oh, thank you. I mean, thank you very much, Nola. I mean, I really don't know what I'd do without you.
So you just have to, put the pieces together and then cross-reference them and then, figure it out.
Definitely.
From there.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I thought we were so lucky when we found, that original piece. And now we're, we find this piece. And, this just could be the find of the decade. So we have to go out and dig, some more.
Mm-hmm.
for some pieces. And then there's no telling where it could happen. What are you doing?
Well, has it been that long that that you have to ask?
No, I mean, but you just can't, you know, you can't prance in here and act like we're still married or something and take advantage of me like this.
Okay, all right, I got carried away, okay?
Okay,
well, it's for a second there. I mean, it just seemed like old times. I mean, you and me working on a find together. So I apologize. I mean, I really, really apologize if I came on too strong.
Don't do it again.
If you don't want me to, I promise. But would have been a hell of a kiss.
Have you heard a word that I've said?
I've heard every single word you said. Look, Nola, honestly, okay? I do not want to push you away by coming on too strong. I will say this, though, that I have a very, very strong feeling that this could be our best Thanksgiving ever.
What do you mean, our best Thanksgiving?
Well, nah.
What?
No.
What?
No, maybe it's not the best idea.
What are you talking about?
Well, you said you wanted to take it slow.
Yeah, okay, we'll speed it up enough to get to the point.
Well, okay. Jay invited me to Thanksgiving dinner here.
He did?
Yeah, but like I said, no. Like I said, it's probably not the best idea. So I will let you know about the Potter.
But wait. You can't walk out now.
Nola, really. I understand perfectly if you don't want me at your table.
Oh. Oh, well, and, but, you know, I mean, it's bad enough that Stacy can't be here, and you know Jay would never forgive me if I kept you away from him here, and I just think it would be, it just wouldn't be good for you to be alone in a restaurant all alone on Thanksgiving.
No. Really, it's okay?
No, I mean, you know, just you be here with bells on.
Well, yes, ma'am, then. I will be here.
Okay.
Thank you.
Well, thank you. Wait a minute. What the hell? What the heck just happened?
Yes, you were arrogant. You were selfish. Still, you are the most important voice for the poor and disenfranchised that I can think of.
They deserved a whole lot better, Charles.
Maybe so. But I think they've forgiven you for the greater good.
Well, I haven't forgiven myself.
Then do what you have to do. Do what you have to do. You have the ability to change the way people think about minorities, and that, sir, is a gift. But if you're going to make a difference, you have to get out there.
Well, I'm going to get back out there. But not until I can look people in the eye and tell them they can believe in me.
Okay. Just don't take too long, though.
Well, I won't. But for now, I'm going to focus on that young man right over there. Until I get his respect, I'm not asking for anybody else's.
Good luck, then.
Thank you.
Just don't take too long, though. See, my son still works for your organization. I don't want him to be out of a job. Might fool around and want to come home.
Well, I'll make sure that doesn't happen.
All right.
Hello, son.
Didn't realize that you and Dr. Grant had become such, great pals.
Well, he was just asking about my career prospects now that I've decided to stay in Springfield.
You're a popular guy. You do just fine.
Except with the person I most want to be popular with. Marcus, look, I know I've done a lot of shameful things. None worse than lying to you and abusing your trust. I'm gonna do all I can to get that trust back. On your terms, however long it takes. I just want you to know that I'm very proud to be your father. More proud, I'm sure, than you are to be my son.
See you around, Dad.
I don't know, Mr.
Michelle. I think it might be over for us.
That's jumping the gun a little, don't you think?
I don't know what to think. That's just it.
Okay. So maybe he's separated or divorced, or he never married and he stupidly didn't listen to the safe sex lectures at school. Marcus wouldn't be the first guy to have a kid with another woman.
What? It's not that.
Then what?
Well, Marcus obviously doesn't care about me as much as I thought he did, or else he'd tell me the truth. Good luck.
I hope everything works out.
All right, well, I better get back to Marie. Are you coming over?
No, I actually have to run. I have something to do.
Okay,
see you around.
See
you. If you're going to see Stephanie, be careful.
Would you stop worrying about me?
Michelle?
Yeah, hi.
What are you doing here?
Well, I heard great things about this place, so I came to check out the crowd.
Karen Elkin.
Matt Reardon.
Nice to meet you.
She's one of Jay's friends from school.
Do you mind if I join you?
Actually, no, but I have to run, so I hope you don't mind.
Not at all.
Great. Well, bye.
Bye, Matt.
Phone. I need another phone. I left Tulsa in the middle of a case.
Last time you ate.
Oh, I'm not hungry.
You look pale. I'm worried about you.
I really can't think about eating.
Sit down. I'll get something in the cafeteria.
I'm going with you. I need to stretch these old legs.
Are you okay?
Yeah, thanks.
Joshua, you didn't answer me. Will you look after my daughter?
Sarah, Reva doesn't need... You need to look after her. She doesn't. She's a grown-up girl, you know. She's got a husband.
You and Reva, you're the most stubborn people I've ever known.
Do you need some water?
No.
Do you need to sit up more?
No.
Should I get the doctor?
No.
Easy.
Reva.
Okay.
Reva.
Forget her.
What's wrong? Say something, please. Talk to me.
Be good to each other. There's nothing that you can't forgive if you try.
I'm gonna go get a doctor.
No, there's any time.
Yes, there is. There's plenty of time. There's all kinds of time. I'm gonna go get someone.
No, honey. Don't you have regrets? Love each other. You were meant to be.
You two anything?
I'd love a bite to eat. How about you,
Matt? No, thanks. Sorry, I really gotta get going.
Oh, Matt, wait. You haven't eaten anything.
I know, I'm not hungry.
Oh, how about a burger with blue cheese?
Some other time, though.
Oh, well, I'm sure this young lady would appreciate the company.
The only young lady that I want for company. No offense.
If anybody can help Matt, it's Nola. She'll be able to find somebody for him.
You want Nola to play matchmaker?
Yes, I do. She's good at it.
Okay, where do I come in?
I want you to just make up anything, any kind of story to convince her that I wrote this letter before the car accident. Will you do that? Can you do that? Okay, now listen. I want you to listen to this and make sure it makes sense and that it seems okay.
Okay.
Dear Nola, please forgive the formality of this letter. I'm writing it to you because I can't bear to say the truth out loud to anybody, not even myself. It scares me too much. This illness is advancing more rapidly than I led you to believe. It won't be long before I won't be able to hear or think or feel or see. The doctors give me maybe a couple of weeks, a few months at most. Please, I want you to help Matt find somebody. You see, I can't bear the thought of his being at my bedside forever, being responsible for somebody who can't even feel his presence. Please, Nola, I'm begging you. Please help him find somebody to share his life with in love and joy. I need you to do this. I need you to do this so that I have some peace of mind. Please, help me find my... Please, help me give my beloved happiness, the happiness that he deserves. What do you think? Do you think that's okay? Look at it. Is the handwriting so legible? Does it look like my handwriting?
It's fine. It's fine.
Good. Take this. Give it to her.
You're an amazing lady, Vanessa. Take care.
Yeah. Thanks.
You're a little quiet today. Are you okay?
Oh, sure. Yeah, fine.
Good, because I've got something I want to ask you.
Oh, Marcus, whatever it is, I'm sure if we talk honestly about it, we can handle
it. Whoa. It's not that big a deal. I want to know what you're doing for Turkey Day.
Oh, I'm going to go visit my mom at the halfway house in the morning, and then the Coopers probably expect me to eat with them.
Can you get out of it? There's somebody special I'd really like you to meet.
Somebody special?
Yeah.
Who?
Well, it's a surprise. If you can make it, of course.
Oh, yeah, sure. I can make it. Yeah. I'll just talk to Frank and Eleni, and I'll be here to meet whoever it is you want me to meet.
Okay, cool. Great.
Stop! What is your hurry, for heaven's sake?
I'm tired, Noah. I want to go home.
Oh, for heaven's sake. You know, she's very pretty.
I don't care.
And she's very nice. But why wouldn't it hurt? I mean, would it hurt to have dinner with her?
I know what you're trying to do, Noah. No, thank you.
It's only dinner. I'm not talking marriage or anything. I mean, you know, it's been 3 months since Vanessa died.
And that is nothing compared to the life that we should have had together. Good night, Noah.
I can barely see your face anymore. Please, dear Lord, give me some more time. Give me just a little more time so that I can commit his face to my memory. Don't let me go into the darkness alone. Please.
It's gonna be okay. You just relax, okay? Just take deep breaths, Mama. Just take deep breaths. You can hear me, can't you? You can hear me right now, can't you, Mommy? Mom. It's okay. Don't go, Mel. Mel. It's too soon. Joshua, can someone do something?
If I can't.
No, please, just get somebody now.
It's too late.
No.
She's gone.
No. 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 No, I can't.